I'm accomplishing something for me. What's stopping you from being the guy that goes home and changes your life?
It's not easy to come in here and pick shit out of yourself.
I was a failure. I'm gonna change my life.
Couch potato, Gary Roberts, you are dead.
That's just a warm up, dude. Fucking man. Never gets easier, man.
Am I interrupting something, gentlemen?
Wow, that was the hardest workout I've ever had.
Well, I'm actually contemplating suicide.
What? Yeah! We're going to talk about sex. Hey, you look more doable.
You're 3 steps away. Don't stop yet. Come on, work until the time is up.
No, I was offered sex.
You get 2 minutes rest afterwards. Don't give me that. Jumping over like this? Bullshit.
I don't want to see any of this crap.
And every rep counts.
I'm going to start working on my stuff. I'm going to change me, and let's see if other shit comes together. Who am I being? Hardest one yet, buddy.
You alright?
It's 12 weeks.
Times and 4 workouts?
Times 4 workouts. So about 50.
So you've done 50 CrossFit workouts.
Yeah, and I'm almost... Do you want to see? I have stopped worrying about it, especially in the holidays. I ate on Christmas and New Year's. So, I mean, I'll stop talking about weight. Talking about fitness. Fitness, fitness, fitness. More fitness. But with my clothes on, 203.4, I mean, if we didn't have New Year's or Christmas, I'd be 200 pounds, but that's a fact. So... Now when I'm feeling like this, now I'm gonna concentrate on improving my fitness, not necessarily worried about fat, eating right, you know, just I'm now, if I'm not moving at some time during the day, I feel I gotta do something.
How easy, let's show me one pull-up. How easy is one pull-up for you now? All right, that's good, save yourself.
So today's a little different. So we're coming in early. I'm gonna film another guy in the box, Corey Major. We're also showing Anissa the gym for the very first time.
Anissa or Anissa?
Anissa.
Anissa.
Anissa. So she's gonna see.
That?
That's the spouse.
The spouse?
My man titties have disappeared. So listen, I don't know. I've been on the military a long time. I don't know if I'm degrading the uniform. So for anyone out there, if I am...
Go closer to the window where it's brighter.
So, it's not a perfect fit by any means, but considering where it was, all right, so it's not perfect, right? Still tight, but I even think my upper body's thicker than when I wore this before. I even have the hat. I still have that. Platoon, Utton, left face. This is a big day. It's the very first workout, the first day we came in here. I remember how much the air squats were crushing me. I mean, the push-ups I did okay, but the pull-ups I had to do assisted. I could barely even do 10 assisted. I can't wait. I've been wanting to redo this one, just see where I'm at. I'll kill that so fast.
How do you feel like this is the first time your wife's going to watch you do a workout? How does that make you feel?
I think that's cool. You know, I try to talk to her about what CrossFit is, what it feels like, and she... I mean, you can describe it all you want, but until you actually see someone getting busted and just crack down and be as intense as possible.
So what do you think about the transformed Gary?
I think it's weird.
I think he's looking good.
Yesterday, I walked into the room and he was there and he was facing that way and I came in from that way and I didn't even think, I thought it was someone else. I was like, who's that tall skinny man standing in my living room? I didn't know it was him. I thought it was someone else.
You're looking good.
I've been telling people, every time I tell someone about CrossFit, they say, well, blah, 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 blah. I say, no, you don't understand. I haven't done the same workout yet. 3 months, different workout every day. I said, in fact, if there's one flaw that I could find in CrossFit, it's that I want to test my time to an earlier workout, but I've yet to duplicate one, so I don't know if I'm what. I know I'm making gains. But I haven't seen the CrossFit's about the stats, the numbers, the documenting. So this is the first time. It's like a big day for me to look back.
So did you think Gary was going to be able to do this? You think your dad was going to be able to do this?
No. I used to call him fat.
You were going to like flex in the city?
Ew, don't do that. Ew.
But he did really good. He surprised everybody because I can tell when everybody saw him in the gym, nobody think he'd be able to do it.
Hey, be respectful on camera.
I'm just leaning this way because this is like...
We don't run that kind of house. Get up. Cover your shirt. Lift up your shirt there. So I don't... What did we say? I don't think I ever wore this shirt. It was brand new. I don't... The ironic part is I don't know how it got stained. Because I pulled it out. I wanted to wear it. And it has a stain on it.
You said you wore it around the house. So this is the gray shirt in week 4 that you wanted to fit into, and now it's too big on you.
Yeah. Yeah, now it is too big.
Oh, now I remember. Oh my gosh. Wow. I was saying that I don't even remember what Gary looked like before. He's just crazy. Like, this is what he looks like to me.
Yeah. I want to kill it. And it's ironic. This was my first workout. This would be her first officially into the gym. Man. Yeah. Hopefully.
All right, so let's do a quick warm-up.
Hopefully we killed that guy. After looking back on some of those videos, I've made a promise to myself not to... I mean, I can't. It happens all the time, right? People say, oh, like I was visiting family who hasn't seen me in a long time. Some family, I met some cousins for the first time ever. And so we're talking about losing weight. One of the comments was, oh, you'll be fat again. You're Roberts. And just because my last name is Roberts, not gonna accept the ultimate fate. Oh, we're fatties. Is that true? Or are we just not willing to put in the effort, do the work? So, man.
It's interesting, the coordination aspect. I don't know if it was just the fat getting in the way or if he's really was just totally not coordinated. But I found like he's found some sort of coordination. I'm watching and is actually doing exactly what it is that they're telling him to do, not okay, in a modified way, or so it's kind of crazy to watch because he's kind of always been the one that's like, oh wait let me try that again, because he doesn't usually get it on the first day.
There's only 10 at the end, so good job, Gary. Yeah,
my wife, you see this picture?
Yeah.
My daughter's 15. She's maybe one in that picture. This is the first and only ever portrait we ever took as a family. For years I've asked, hey, can we go get family pictures? Can we go get family pictures? There's like a gap of like the last 7 years where there's no family photos. It's weird. And I remember saying we should get family pictures. We get family pictures. And I always said, well, I don't want to get pictures. I just lose some weight. No good pictures. Lose some weight. Go get pictures. So with arm wrestling, I have pictures in the last couple of years that are all just god-awful, fat, disgusting me. And then I'm looking through the pictures in the first couple of years when I met my wife. And I was like, hey, who's that guy? I forgot that guy even existed.
Sub 7.
I think he's got a. I think he's going sub 5. I think he's gonna cut it in half. He's cut himself in half. I don't know why he wouldn't cut the time in half.
And the funny thing is while we were doing this, you asked me, "Is your wife excited? Is she jumping your bones? You know, she getting excited about you?" And I said, "No, nothing, nothing. Hasn't done anything." And then we had that one week where it was kind of like something happened, and then I went up there and
went to Portland.
Went to Portland, and all this attention. Not used to it, right? We talked about it. I talked to my wife. She gets so upset. She thinks I've done something wrong. You must have been acting different, and you must have been doing something. So then I come home. I walk in the door, and I pretty much say, hey, I don't know if you and I are going to make it. Because I think it's a travesty that I've been training now for 2.5 months and I've gotten more attention from complete strangers than my own spouse. I think that's the problem. And it just highlighted other issues that we've had.
As opposed to 3 months ago, how is Gary
Wow. How's your husband changed? A lot in so many ways. I think the last time that I talked to you about it, there were some subtle changes. I mean, a little changes physically a little bit. And
because she says, hey, you were fat. I didn't want to have sex with a fat guy. I was not attracted. I avoided at all costs to be anywhere near you. Yeah, you were fat. A lot of rejection. I lack a loving, and she was not into the loving, at least with me. No, I mean, she said, hey, I'm just not into it.
But my goodness, like all of a sudden it's like, oh, he did the exercise and then he started the whole 30-day paleo thing. And then I think as soon as he started that, and then there was like some real drastic weight loss and change, and he started feeling much better about himself, I guess. Just in general, everything totally different. The first thing I really noticed and I kept saying to him was, gosh, thanks for being so helpful. Gosh, thanks for pitching in. Gosh, thanks, you've been really nice lately.
But my wife, when I came home from Portland, she said, hey, the intimacy stopped because you got fat. And she's like whitewashing all the troubles throughout the year. She's now spent the last 7 days jumping my bones. She's been chasing me. She's been acting like I've never seen her before. Never. Not even in the early days. She's never gone to bed with her clothes off. She's always cold and kind of layers and layers. And it's like impenetrable, like a prison. You can never get some action once she's gone to bed. This week, naked. Straight up naked. I'm like, you've never gone to bed naked in your life. She's like, oh, it's easier to stay warm. I said, wait, are you smoking? What is going on? I said, are you telling me that this is all switcheroo because I got hit on this weekend? You're now flipping the and you're saying, now I'm a sexy beast. I want you. Well, yeah, I didn't want you before because you're fat. Now I want you. I'm like, what? No. I didn't just get fat and then you stopped wanting me. We had problems and you didn't want me. Early on, many, many, many years ago, she's like, you were fat and unhappy and grumpy and you were an asshole. You were mean. And now that you're with CrossFit, you're happy and you look good and you're sexy. And now I want you. Now you're not mean. So in like 24 hours.
It was more about, gosh, well, how are you interacting with everybody? And what's the differences there? And it was making a big difference. And then all of a sudden it was like, okay, you're losing weight, you can tell the difference. And then like overnight, one night, it went from 1 week to the next week, just a complete overhaul of, not only did he was losing weight, but then all of a sudden it was like, now the toning was coming out. His whole body structure changed. And it really went from, was that fast, like 1 week to the next. And he keeps going, oh no, it's not. It's cause you know, I'm more attractive to people now and this and that. And I kept saying, no, it's not that. Like it was that fast. And it has taken, I don't know how many other people have said the same thing. No, Gary. He's like, well, I looked the same, you know, a week before that. No, you didn't. It went like from, you're looking good, you're looking good, you're looking better, you're looking good, to, oh my gosh, what happened to you? Like, you don't look like the same person at all.
Okay, and three,
two, one.
After this, your legs get to rest. Push hard here. This is the last time you have to use your legs in this workout. Come on, push. Chest up, push. Nice, Gary.
How many is this?
Six.
30.
16. Sorry. Nice. Keep that ass up. Make him good.
One, two, three.
There you go.
Six. Seven.
Go. Go.
can move so fast.
I felt like I could have done better. Some slight adjustments. 5 minutes rest and I'm going up that rope.
Yeah. Have you ever climbed the rope?
Marine Corps. She's now thinking, because we've had amazing sex for the last 7 days, that all her problems have been whitewashed away and life is perfect. You're doing CrossFit, you're taking care of yourself. That's so much more exciting. I'm so much more into you because you're taking care of yourself. And it's so much more easy to be into someone who's trying to do something for themselves. I'm like, what? Okay. Yes, my energy was misplaced. I was not taking care of myself. We discussed this. We said, you know, hey, we could probably help people. I'm sure there's other people going through the same issues, so we're going to be honest. You know, I told them what's been going on. I told them you've been jumping my bones.
Great, thanks.
So the world knows. So you might as well just let it out there. Right. That what? How do? 1 week before I left, you didn't want me to then I come back. Well, so now, come on.
I don't know. It's the not want. Again, it was a slower transition for me. It was like, you know, and I feel guilty almost saying, or kind of like a bad person. You know, you're supposed to love your spouse unconditionally, which I did to all other extent. But sometimes, you know, that physical appearance, I mean, it's not the person you're used to. It's not the person you met or not the person you married. And I mean, outwardly. And it sounds really, really shallow. But again, after talking to people and they're like, no, Anissa, I totally get it. And I had been saying this to him and I had been saying it to my friends, you know, I don't know if he would just, even as a big fat guy, if he would just clean himself up.
Friggin' sexy, throwing herself around. She tackled me on the bed this morning like, hey, what's up? I'm like, who are you?
Are you enjoying it?
I'm enjoying it, but at the same time, it's almost like, seriously? She says, hey, I'm sorry. I'm not trying to be shallow. It just is what it is. I wasn't into you. So I put clothes on so you wouldn't bother me.
It's the difference between somebody putting an effort in and somebody not. And I think he was just beyond even wanting to put the effort in.
We talked about this. What? We talked about this.
Okay. I do. I think it's just beyond wanting to put the effort in. And then when you see somebody who doesn't care about their own appearance, it's really hard to be into their appearance as an outward person, seeing it from that other side. And so it's very hard to be attracted to somebody who, plain and simple, kind of just doesn't give a shit about themselves.
So his personality's gotten better, he's emotionally better, right, and physically better.
And like, I mean, it's like, so, he's turned into, like, I just told him the other day, I said, oh my God, you're like turning into the prince who comes in on the white horse. Like, you know all these, you see all of these things, and you know, it's the thing. It's like, for so long I've lived with the fat husband, and yes, you accept him for who he is and all of those things. Honestly though, are you physically attracted to it? Not really. I mean, and it's hard. You do have that inner struggle, and as a wife and as somebody who loves this person, like, loves the person that they are, but it's hard outwardly for that.
I was, that first couple days, I was judging her. I was saying, hey, shouldn't matter how fat I am, she'd love me for me and want to be with me regardless. But then I started rewatching some of the older video in the last couple days, looking at pictures, saying, yeah, I wouldn't want to hit that either. So, can I judge you for that?
Now it's like, all of a sudden, now it's, I don't know if he's just at an age where everything now has come together with the maturity and the emotional changes and him feeling good about himself, and that makes such a big difference, reflects on everybody else. I mean, he was fighting so badly with our daughter for quite some time. I mean, that virtually almost has come to a complete halt. I mean, there's a thing there too. She's a teenager, what do you want? But, you know, I mean, nothing like what it was. And so I think it's just so much because he's been so much happier with himself
again, reflects on everything else. And then, you know, on top of that, he loves the way he looks. He looks fantastic. So yes, physically, yes, I look at him and I see a better guy, man, than I actually even married. I mean, he was a skinny guy when I married him, but now he's like taking care of himself. He has like a pride in himself that he's never had.
It's no fair that you've been fat and nasty for years. Now that you're suddenly looking good, I don't get a shot at trying to make this right while you're hot. You're just gonna... I said, well, you have a point, but I didn't... Well, Jim didn't magically become fat. We had problems before that. So that's where I'm at, man. I don't know. I know that I had more sex in the last 7 days than I've had in 2 years. I'm like, what?
Is she pregnant again?
No. Yeah, so there's this other guy in the gym. He's got a really cool story. His name's Corey. I don't know what his weight is today, but when he first came into the CrossFit gym, I was told he was about 450. I'll find out specifically tonight. I'm going to interview him, find out his story, and watch him work out.
And so then you're going to submit it to the journal?
Yeah.
It's your first CrossFit piece?
It'll be my first piece. So, I told Anissa, I put her through a WOD last night.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
How was that?
She complained a lot in the beginning. She was making excuses about what she didn't like, how she didn't want to do it, how she's not going to have any time. And I said, listen, stop the bitching. Let's just get on with it. She was talking about the diet. She didn't know about doing no bread, no carbs and all that. So I said, look, we got a good, we'll do a benchmark. It's 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Burpees, push-ups, and air squats. So I put her through that last night. What did you get, 12?
Oh, man, 457.
How do your muscles feel?
Actually, nothing. They're sore. Yeah. My legs are a little sore, but they weren't.
About how she's not going to be able to walk for 2 days, and it's all my fault.